Welcome to the class, students. Today in this class, we are moving to another chapter in your first BU syllabus, that is chapter 8, interpolation and the extrapolation. Let us see the definitions for these two, interpolation and the extrapolation. See, first the definition of interpolation says that interpolation is a procedure of estimating the unknown value of dependent variable. Here the dependent variable is always y. Dependent variable y. For a given value of independent variable, your independent variable is x, which is within the limits or range of the independent variable. That is, here we are finding the dependent values, that is y values, using the independent values, that is x given x values, within the limits means here we are having a certain years. Okay, for that, within that year, if the values are missing, that we are going to find using the data, that is independent variables or range of the independent variable, whatever the range they have given, whatever the limit they have given, within that limit, if you find out the missing values, that we call it as the interpolation. That means between the years or within the range or within the limits we are finding, that we call it as a interpolation. Next definition says it is extrapolation. Extrapolation is a procedure of estimating the unknown value of, again, independent value. Independent value is always y. For a given value of dependent variable or a value, it is x, which is outside the limits or range of the independent value. Outside the limit means for the next year, we can find out for the next year. For example, if you are having the data till 2020, so 2021 we can find out that. That method we call it as extrapolation. So outside the limits also, or a range of the independent variable, outside the range of the independent variable, if you find the dependent value, that we call it as the extrapolation. Before we are finding this interpolation and the extrapolation, we have some assumptions of interpolation and the extrapolation. There is no sudden jumps in value of dependent variable from one period to another. Second one, the rate of change of figures of the dependent variable from one period to another must be uniform. So these two are the assumptions of interpolation and the extrapolation. Next is, we have certain methods to calculate the interpolation. One is algebraic method, another one is graphical method. But here for your syllabus we are having only algebraic method. In that algebraic method also we have three methods. Out of that, one we are using, that is binomial expansion method. So one of the method to find out the interpolation and the extrapolation is binomial expansion method. Here that too with the one missing value. For your syllabus, you are having only with one missing value, you have to find the dependent variables using binomial expansion method. To get that, to form this binomial expansion formula, here we have one Pascal triangle. Using this Pascal triangle only, we can write the coefficients for the unknown or unknown values. Okay, let me write the Pascal triangle. This is our Pascal triangle. Here you are having n, and here I should have a sum. Okay, for different n values we are having the coefficients. For different n values we will write down the coefficients. Now if n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 8. Here for n different till 8 values, we have to we can find the coefficients and the sums. For n is equal to 1, it is 1, 1, and 1. For n equals 2, this 1 will be same. 1 plus 1 is 2, again 1. Next, here for n equals 3, so that it is easy to write the coefficient for that different n values. Okay, now for n equals 3, 1 will remain same. 1 plus 2 is 3, 2 plus 1 is also 3, again 1. Next, 1 will be same. 1 plus 3 is equal to 4, 3 plus 3 is 6, 3 plus 1 is 4, again 1. Next, 1 will remain same. 1 plus 4 is equal to 5, 4 plus 6 is 10, 10, 5. 1, next 1, 6, 15, 20, 15, 6, 1, next 1, 7, 21, 35, 35, 21, 7 and 1, lastly it is 1, it is 8, 28, 56, 70, 56, 28, 8, 1. So once again I'll repeat this procedure. For n equals 1, the coefficient is 1 and 1 only. For n equals 2, this 1 will remain same. 1 plus 1 is 2 and again this 1 will remain same. Next, for n equals 3, 1 will remain same. 1 plus 2 is 3. 2 plus 1 is also 3, again 1. Next, n equals 4, 1 will remain same. 1 plus 3 is equal to 4, 3 plus 3 is 6, 3 plus 1 is 4, again 1. Next, 1 will remain same. 1 plus 4 is 5, 4 plus 6 is 10, 6 plus 4 is also 10, 4 plus 1 is 5, again 1. 1 plus 5, 1 will remain same. 1 plus 5 is 6. 5 plus 10 is 15, 10 plus 10 20, 10 plus 5 15, 5 plus 1 6, again 1, 1 will remain same, 1 plus 6 is 7, 7, 6 plus 15 it is 21, 15 plus 20 35, 20 plus 15 35, 15 plus 6 21, 6 plus 1 7, again 1 will remain same, 1 will remain same. 1 plus 7 is 8, 7 plus 21 is 28, 21, 50, 35 is 56, 35, 35, 70, 35, 21, 56, 21, 7, 28, 7 plus 1, 8, again 1 will remain same. You just observe this. See, this is how the Pascal triangle looks. So it is symmetric. You just observe this. Here this symmetric. If we fold this, you will get the symmetric values. So this is how the Pascal triangle we have formed for different n values. To write the expansion for binomial expansion method, this Pascal triangle is very, very important. This Pascal triangle is very, very important. Okay. So, using this Pascal triangle, next we are going to write the coefficients to find out the missing value using binomial expansion method. So, this Pascal triangle is very, very important. I didn't write the sum. I will write the sum now. It is 1 plus 1 is 2. 1, 2, 1, 4. 3, 3, 1, 3, 3, 1, 6, 7, 8, 5, 10, 15, 16, next, 20, 30, 32, 30, 50, 62, 63, 64. Next, after 64, it is 128. It is 256. So it's 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256. This is, you can check this. This is in the form of 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 square, 2 cube, 2 power 4. Like that, it is there. Okay. Yeah, I have written the sum of this values, the coefficient values. This is very, very important, Pascal triangle, for your second POC also. Again, we are continuing the same concept, interpolation and extrapolation. There also we will use this Pascal triangle. So please go through this one. Next, let us solve some problems on binomial expansion method. In the following table, problems in following table, value of x represent degrees of freedom. Degrees of freedom and y value represent chi square value at 5% LOS. Find missing value. Find missing value. Your x, x, y, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Y value 5.99, 7.81, 9.49, 11.07, 14.07. Okay. So these are the x values and the y values. This x values represent the degrees of freedom and y is the LOS, the level of significance values, LOS values for chi square variate at 5% LOS, and we denoted x and y. Here we know that x is nothing but the independent variables and y is always a dependent variable. Here let us denote this y variables with y naught, y1, y2, y3, y4 and the y5. So here our n is equal to 5. See, your at last value n is equal to 5. So we have to take the Pascal triangle coefficient and the y minus 1 to the power 5 is equal to 0. So we have to equate this equation, we have to equate this binomial expansion to the 0 with y minus 1 to the power 5, because your n is equal to 5. Last value is y5, so that is 5, y5. So n is equal to 5, y minus 1 to the power, y minus 1 whole to the power 5 is equal to 0. We have to equate this to 0. Next, we have to write the expansion for n is equal to 5. See, already we have seen the Pascal triangle. Again, I'll rewrite this simply. I'll write here. Let it be here only. For n is equal to, for different n values, here I'll write simple one is 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1, 1, 4, 6, 4, 1, 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1, 1, 6, 15, 20, 15, 6, 1, 1, 7, 21, 35, 35, 21, 7, 1. Here for different n values, here I have written, this is n is equal to 1, n equals 2, n equals 3, n equals 4, n is equal to 5, n is equal to 6 and n is equal to 7. For different n values, I have simply have written here. Already you know how to write frame this one. So here I have written very in a simple manner. Okay. This is n is equal to 7. Okay. Let it be here only for our problem sake. Here n is equal to 5. So for n is equal to 5, this is the coefficients. For n is equal to 5, these are the coefficients. First, I'll write the coefficients. That is 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1. Okay? First, I'll write the coefficients. Next, I will write the y values, dependent values. I'll start from y5. It is y5, y4, y3, y2, y1. y0, which should be equated to 0 because here we have equated to 0, but in between we should have the sign. Okay, first this one will be plus, this will be minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. It should have an alternative sign with the coefficients. Once again I will repeat this, how I have taken this coefficient. Here I have denoted these y values as y0, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5. Here n is equal to 5. So y minus 1 to the power 5 is equal to 0. Delta power 5 is also 0. We can rewrite that. For n is equal to 5, in Pascal triangle, see here, these are the coefficients. 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1. These are the coefficients. First, I have written the coefficients. 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1. Next, have taken the y values in the starting from y5, y4, y3, y2, y1, y0, and it should be equated to 0. And the sign for this expansion, first one will be plus. We should take the alternative signs, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. Got it? This is how we have written this expansion. Now, next step is we have to substitute the y values in this equation. Okay, substitute the y values. y5 is 14.07 minus 5 times y4 we don't know, that we have to find, plus 10 into y3. y3 value is 11.07 minus 10. y2 is 9.49 plus 5 into y1 is 7.81 minus 1 time y0 is 5.99. It is equated to 0. Next we have to simplify this. It is 163.82 minus 100.89 minus 5y4 is equal to 0. See here, this is plus, plus and plus. All the plus values is this and all the negative values, these two are the negative values. This will be this one and minus 5y5 will be here only. Now we have to simplify this. You have to subtract. It is 62.93 minus 5y4 is equal to 0. Next. 62. Here I'll shift this minus to this side. 62.93 is equal to 5y4 or y4 is equal to 62.93 divided by 5 and this y4 value is 12.586. So our missing value y4 is equal to 12.586. Missing value is 12.586. So this is how we have found out the one missing value using the binomial expansion method. And here Pascal triangle is very, very important. Okay. Next one. Next problem. Using suitable method of interpolation, estimate sales in 2004. So this is the problem here they have given. Here we want to find the y value for 2004. We have to estimate the value for 2004. That value is missing. First I'll denote this. It is y naught, y1, y2, y3, y4 and the y5. y5 till y5 we have to. So here again the expansion is y minus 1 to the power 5 is equal to 0. Again I will rewrite this one. It is 1 1 1 2 1 1 3 3 1 1 4 6 4 1 1 5 10 10 5 1 1 6 15 20 15 6 1. For different n values, this is n is equal to 1, n equals 2, n equals 3, n equals 4, n is equal to 5, n is equal to 6. Okay, so here again we want 5. For n is equal to 5, these are the coefficients. First I will write the coefficients. 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1. Next, I'll take the y values. It is y5, y4, y3, y2, y1, y0. Now, you have to write the sign, alternative signs, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, and it is equated to 0. Plus minus plus minus, at last it should be equated to 0. Next, take down the next substitute the y values. y5 is 780 minus 5, y4 is 525 plus 10, y3, because we don't know the y3 value, I'll take as it is, minus 10, y2 365 plus 5, y1 235 minus y naught, it is 150 equal to 0. Next, simplify this. This is 780 minus 2656. It is 1955 plus 10y3 minus 6425 is equal to 0. All the plus values, I'll make it once. And all the minus values, I've taken it as once. So it is 10y3 minus 4470 is equal to 0. I'll shift to this to right hand side. 10y3 is equal to 4470. y3 is equal to 4470 divided by 10. So y3 is equal to 447. So 447 is our missing value. This is how we have find out the missing values using binomial expansion method. And here the Pascal triangle is very, very important. Next problem. Use the binomial expansion method to ascertain the most likely index number for the year 1983. First, let us denote this value index. Here we will take it as x and index as y. So first you will denote this y naught, y1, y2, y3 and y4. Here till y4 n is equal to 4 we are having. So y minus 1 to the power 4 is equal to 0. For n is equal to 4 here we have to take the coefficients. For n equals 4 it is 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. First I will write down the coefficients 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. Next, we have to write the y values. From y4 we should start. Y4, y3, y2, y1, y0. Next, write down the signs, alternative signs. Plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. It should be equated to 0. Once again, I'll repeat this. For n is equal to 4, I have taken. You just see the Pascal triangle. In this Pascal triangle, for n is equal to 4, it is 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. Okay. For this, these are the coefficients. For this coefficients, I have taken the y values. I started from y4 till y0. Then the signs. The sign should be alternative. Plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. And at last, it should be equated to 0. Now, you have to substitute the y values. It is 3, 4, y3, I don't know. Plus 6, sorry, y3 is there, 4 into 157, plus 6 y2, I don't know, minus 4 y1 is 107, plus 100 is equal to 0. It is 312 plus 6 y2 minus 1056 is equal to 0. 6 y2 is equal to 744, y2 is equal to 744 divided by 6. So, y2 is equal to 124. So, this is how we have calculated the missing value. Y2 is equal to 124. For examination, you will get one question from this interpolation, the extrapolation, that too for 5 marks. If they ask the definitions and the assumptions, it may be for 1 mark and 2 mark. The problems will be for 5 marks. Thank you.